Well, I'm here to tell you about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting trains you for a career in radio, TV, and web design on air and behind the scenes. Classes meet 3 days or nights a week, and in less than a year, you'll be ready to start your career in broadcasting. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting offers hands-on training, exciting internships, job placement assistance, and financial aid for those who qualify. They'll help get you into a career that you can love at their suburban campus in Lombard. They're enrolling now for upcoming classes, and seats are filling up quickly. To get started, go to beonair.com/rock. That's beonair.com/rock, or you can text rock to 33239. That's rock to 33239. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
SportsTownChicago.com is your place for NIHL high school club hockey. Every goal, all of the checks, and every jarring hit. SportsTownChicago.com, in a league of our own.
Hi, I'm Steve Mehlhausen, host of the Fight Club, right here on SportsTownChicago.com. And if you want to hear exciting highlights like this,
I mean, you can go deep.
Oh, he got rocked!
Dos Santos looking for the finish!
He's out!
It is all
He's out.
Over!
Good left hand! The end is there!
Make sure you tune in to the only MMA show here in Chicago. So make sure you tune in to the Fight Club on SportsTownChicago.com.
With football season finally around the corner.
That ain't true!
Yes, it is, and that's why you need the Sports Hump for your pigskin fix. Wednesdays from 10 to 1, Rick and Ian...
They like playing with each other.
Well, that may be true, but they will break down the thoughts of the brightest minds in the game.
Playoffs? Don't talk about playoffs.
I don't know anything.
It's Division I football!
Cannot play with him. Cannot win with him. Cannot coach with him. Can't do it.
Go off any of our geniusness.
So tune in to the Sports Hump Wednesdays from 10 to 1 on SportsTownChicago.com.
Started on
more sensational, inspirational, celebrational, motivational. This is what we call the Muppet Show.
Everything is great, everything is grand. I got the whole wide world in the palm of my hand.
Everything is perfect. It's falling into place. I can't seem to wipe this smile off my face.
Life's a happy song, and there's someone by my side to sing along.
When you're alone, life can be a little rough. It makes you feel like you're 3 foot tall. When it's just you, well, times can be tough. When there's no one there to catch your fall.
Everything is great, everything is grand. I got the whole wide world in the palm of my hand. Everything is perfect, it's falling into place. I can't seem to wipe this smile off my face. Life smells like a rose,
with someone to paint
and someone to pose. Life's a piece of cake, with someone to pedal,
someone to break.
Life is full of glee,
with someone to solve.
Hey guys, it's Pete McMurray. Every time I'm out and about, people always ask, Pete, how do I become a DJ? How can I hang out at cool concerts, go backstage, and most importantly, be on the air? Well, I'm here to tell you about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting trains you for a career in radio, TV, and web design on air and behind the scenes. Classes meet 3 days or nights a week, and in less than a year, you'll be ready to start your career in broadcasting. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting offers hands-on training, exciting internships, job placement assistance, and financial aid for those who qualify. They'll help get you into a career that you can love at their suburban campus in Lombard. They're enrolling now for upcoming upcoming classes, and seats are filling up quickly. To get started, go to beonair.com/rock. That's beonair.com/rock, or you can text ROCK to 33239. That's ROCK to 33239. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
When you and your family want a quick meal everyone will love, put that burger on the back burner and go to Chick-fil-A at 301 East Loop Road in Wheaton. So when that burger needs a break, eat more chicken at Chick-fil-A.
You want to do a live sports show with up to three of your friends?
Yeah.
Would you like to be invited to live sporting events?
Well, yeah.
Well, you can now with SportsTownChicago.com. SportsTown Chicago is the home of the ICB Sports Network. Learn blogging, podcasting, and promos right here at SportsTownChicago.com. For more information, go to BeOnAir.com or dial 630-916-1700. SportsTownChicago.com. We're in a league of our own.
Hey, this is Dr. Pete, SportsTownChicago.com, inviting you to check out the Team Dow Wellness Tip of the Week. Their weight release program helped me drop over 50 pounds and over 10 pant sizes. Visit our homepage at SportsTownChicago.com or TheEdgeOnAir.com to find out the Team Dow Wellness Tip of the Week.
SportsTownChicago.com. Alex, we got two teams coming up that we have not covered before, and they both look ready and prepared. Court one on SportsTownChicago.com. Dr. Pete alongside the one, the only, Alex Lo Cicero, A-Lo, the Halo. I haven't said that in many a moons, but who do we got coming our way?
We got Muncieana 18, the Skyhawks out of Indiana, taking on the MVA 18-1 team. They are the Michigan Volleyball Academy. So two out of team... Our out-of-state teams, we have not, have we? I don't think we've had that yet today, have we?
Well, we're about to have it now.
Yep.
Because you got the sheets. I guess that means you're doing the call.
You got them right there, I thought.
I do? No.
You got the Skyhawks is the same page as the other Muncieana from earlier, Samurai. And then MVA was a...
Oh, okay.
MVA is that one.
Okay.
They were both on the computer, I thought.
Okay. Don't mind me, folks. Don't mind me.
Well, right now we haven't even started both teams. Interesting to see, though, little ritual, all the girls holding hands up.
Well, that's what friends are for, Alex.
Yeah. So I hear.
Just talked to Mrs. Williams, mother of one of the players, for one question. Really, we're going to take a... Alex, take it away for a second here.
All right, as we are about to get sent on game number four of the day on court one. Two teams we haven't seen, the Skyhawks out of Indiana taking on the Michigan Volleyball Academy. As we are waiting to get underway, back to Pete, we haven't missed a thing. Just saying that we've been waiting for the R1 to blow the whistle for about 45 seconds.
Oh, okay. Well, good to know.
And there we go.
We're underway. Spike, right hand. Keeping alive, good shot by the libero back row off the double tip. Going near side, bump back row. Two-hand redirection there by Ari Anderson. And the Skyhawks up 1-0.
I cannot read what's on the back.
Near side, Muncieana. We're good. Over the top, live webcast too, folks. Don't forget, you can get that video later just clicking on our live stream account. Right hand down over the top by Anderson. Good pickup back row by MVA. High tip off the hands of Wright. Off the double, not able to get there cleanly. It is going to be the libero for MVA.
How about Michigan and Indiana?
That's good.
It's not every day that we can actually go by the states. And, you know, normally they're both in Illinois.
That's true. That's very true. Spike, right hand. Virginia off the, or excuse me, see now I said it wrong. Indiana off the top. Push off to the side. We got a tip, 2-1 your score. And Muncieana is going to be on the board.
And right now at 2-1, both teams, we've seen a lot of quick starts, as we saw with First Alliance, or we saw it with Wisconsin Juniors. We saw a lot of quick starts to a set, and right now 2-1, we are not used to seeing set one start with a little bit of back and forth.
Left hand, Anderson over the top. Good dig down low by Michigan. Decoy, Anderson over the top. Whistle from another court. We play on. Anderson, bump back to Anderson. She goes for the kill. Good dig by the Libro. Push along. And wow, Anderson just keeps bringing that attack for Munciana. And Michigan can't adjust, but good libero play throughout it all by Ariel Masita.
And again, right now it seems like the Skyhawks are, again, communicating well on the offensive end. They're passing clean.
3-2 your score, SportsTownChicago.com. Dr. Pete, Alex and Cicero live here all weekend long. Volleyball coming in from the other court. It is a cluster in the middle of that net right now with about eight players all around. Good tip hand under uppercut there by Bradbury. Redirect there, dig down low. Keeping alive again is Bradbury back on the side of Munciana. Massive kill by number 99, Abby Fleener, signed senior out of Grand Rapids, Michigan. Wow, what a kill. I like that they use like all sets of numbers, that it's not just the basic 1 through 20. 3-3 your score, set outside. Anderson goes for the tip. Anderson kill. 4-3.
Pete, when you played, did you ever get a chance to pick your own number, or were you always stuck with what was already printed?
Sometimes I got to pick, depending on the sport.
What was your go-to number?
13.
Okay.
If allowed, 13. I'll never forget back in the junior high football days. They said, you are a lineman. I said, but I like 13. There's no rule against it. It's in the NFL. And, of course, now the NFL has changed a lot of their numbering rules.
You've had a lot of changes in general in numbers, and I'll say this much. On the broadcast side, it's a lot easier when you know that certain numbers are only for certain positions.
Yes. Yes. Not the case with volleyball, though.
Definitely not.
But not necessarily an issue. Like, if every libero had to be 1 through 2,
you know, that'd be pretty easy.
Know, and then you just do it by tens. You know, middle blocks are in the 90s. You know, like defensive tackles.
Yeah.
There we go. Governing body of volleyball, the AVCA.
Setters have to be in the 30s.
That could work. That could work. Outside hitters are, like a quarterback, I guess you could say.
No, I'd say the quarterback's more of
libero.
A
libero.
Yeah.
Okay. So 1 through 20, or 1 through 19. 6-5 your score, by the way. As our debate continues. Hop serve far side by Davis. Good dig down low. Bump up high by Nasita. Bump over the top. Still alive. Bradbury continues the rally. Outside. Tip over right hand. Good move back there by 67, Kristen Reinders, the signed senior out of Grand Haven, Michigan. 7-5 your score. Hop serve again by Davis. Punch far side, Bradbury. Libero keeps it alive. Harnish. Spike down. Spike. Kill by number. I'm trying to get the correct number. Again, these numbers are so high. Number 68, Jessica Marley out of Belmont, Michigan. 8-5, and we got a timeout.
That we do. You're mentioning Harnish. Check out the interview series as Rick Camp interviews the one and only NIU's Harnish as he gets ready for the NFL draft. Every single week, Rick is doing an interview covering that entire journey. You don't want to miss it. SportsTownChicago.com and click on the Harnish link. I believe it's a picture, too.
Yep, he's harnishing.
Okay. Oh, that's right, yeah. Rick can show me the picture. Rick, of course, harnishes every day.
Yeah, that he does. Most folks out there may have heard of T-Bowing. Rick harnishes. Bump up, libero, spike down. Not able to get the clean block. Is going to be Hunter Wise, junior out of Indiana. Wise, no knee pads. Or has them, and those are just ankle braces. Wise does not wear knee pads. She's like, I am tall, I block. 9-5 your score. We continue along in this rally. High High bump by the Libro. Spike down, not able to get there in time. It's going to be Nasita. And 9-6 is going to be your score.
It's a bold decision. You see it sometimes in high school, just when teams don't necessarily have players that are used to playing year-round or maybe play it more casually. But at the club level, it's an indication that you're never going to see the back row.
Set near side, dig down low by Harnish. Right side over the top. Nasita is able to keep that alive. Redirection there and a kick. Smart kick there, but give the point where points are due. And that is going to be somebody for the Skyhawks that we don't have on our roster here, but she's number 10. So good point, number 10. Good slide down low by McGuire. Bump up, Nasita. 10-foot line, kill attempt, getting it down, nail it down, through the floorboards, Kristen Reinders. Big kill, 10-7.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out, maybe Munciana brought over, I was just trying to look at the numbering system because it's 1 through 9 for the Skyhawks, and I was just trying to see if it's 10 through whatever for Samurai, but that's not the case.
And they have 9 players on the court, so somebody has a different number. I'm just not quite sure who. 7-11, your score. Continuing along in their winning ways right now is MVA. Hit over the top. Marley. And hitting it out of bounds. We're waiting to see who gets the point. They are calling the tip. The line judge calling the tip and checking in. Serve specialist now is going to be Catherine Vasilakis. 11-8 your score. Vasilakis next to the line judge, Petakoukis. I got it. Vasilakis serves over. Picked up cleanly, set near antenna. And they are calling the antenna hit. 11-8 your score. 11-9 your score.
And again, though, Munciana playing well, smart at the net. And if you're Michigan, falling away on the hit, it's always hard to control it. But you got to try to find your balance anytime you're going for an approach.
Vasilakis and Nasita. Spike from the 10-foot line. Good one-hand uppercut punch. It's going to be a joust. And that one goes out of bounds. Did they hit it? No, they didn't. 11-10. And just as we saw MVA taking the lead, Indiana is coming back close.
Yeah, and right now on that one, again, near the antenna play, both teams really walking a fine line near the antenna.
Set far side. Anderson goes for the kill. Kept alive cleanly, Reinders. Set, near side. Nasita keeps alive. Tip over the top. And a reach over there by number 35. Essence Jackson Jones, the middle hitter, signed senior. When you're 6'1", most colleges are going to take a look at you.
You would think so.
Serve over there by Vasilakis. 11-11, we are all tied up. Does that stay in? And it does stay in. Not getting there in time is Courtney Harnish, the D specialist. And 12-11 is going to be your score, as getting the one-point lead again is Munciana.
And again, it's big for Munciana to keep the lead. They're the ones that have been on top here or there. If Michigan can find a way to reverse that, you got to wonder what it's going to do mentally to the Skyhawks.
Anderson with the misguided hit, 13-11, two-point lead. Munciana again leads.
I wonder if they're adding this to run, because Michigan still has the serve. But on the scoreboard, the points have gone to Munciana.
Yeah, maybe they just switched it. We'll find out. Blocked there across the middle by number one, Taylor Wright.
They did switch it. It was tied 11-11. They switched on the scoreboard. Yeah. Who was getting the points. That happens. That happens when your back is to the scoreboard, when you're keeping it.
Yeah. High set, near side, off the double block. Underneath it cleanly is going to be Harnish. Tip down, right across, breaking through. Taylor Wright making it feel wrong.
And again, we're tied at 13, so really, scoreboard could change again on us.
13, exactly. All tied up. Right hand, set serve. Able to clear it as Barker. Off the double block, and that was it was good placement there by the Skyhawks, but it just kind of rolled along the net, not able to make the adjustment.
And Michigan back on top. Munciana has to now try to find a way to do a little more defensively. It's interesting, they only have 3 behind the 10-foot line for the serve receive.
High decoy to Anderson. Anderson down underneath that one. Cleanly is Nasita. 10-foot line kill attempt picked up with a good bump. Is going to be Barker. And rally ends 15-13 now.
Again, Michigan playing well. Net violation could have been called. The R1 could have called a net violation or going over the net. Just let the play resume as it ended in a kill.
Not able to get underneath it is going to be Courtney Harnish. 16-13 now your score. I believe they have that in the right column this time.
That they do. Michigan up by three. And as far as we can
tell. Ladies and gentlemen, Phil Brzezinski just walking by the booth. The one, the only, the legend himself. Volleyball aficionado. 3-point lead. We continue on the rally. Vasilakis. A headband has hit the court. And we're at 16-14.
Better than just someone's head.
Yeah. I believe it was last year, Laura Williams at Alliance Township kept losing her headband.
It's possible.
I joke it's a little too much of the conditioner, I guess. I don't know. Who knows? Anderson. Anderson down. Anderson kill. I did see, looking through the other 18s, though, you were correct. Joel Anderson, the head coach of Peyton, and is coaching one of the teams. And not only that, but he's got his very own Michelle Schultz, a 2011 All-Star, on his team. So...
You look at it, and I don't think it's going to fall into play this morning, but the sports performance team out of Great Lakes here is kind of just like Team Bennett with Jendrick and the Haggerty's and a couple other players from that roster. There's a lot of local talent here this weekend.
Oh, yeah. Most local players that were in the All-Star game are playing in this game and then said teammates at the high school level. Quick one set, but going a bit out of bounds. No tip there. Hunter Wise was calling for it. She didn't get the call. 18-15.
Michigan again with a 3-point lead. So big for them to keep that little distance, keep that little bumper. And right now, Munciana has to try to find a way to come back.
Serve over. Harnish with the bump. Sets up Wise. Dig down low. Harnish keeps the rally going. Anderson over the top. Skyhawk set up at the 10-foot line. Good dig down low by... Dig down low is by Harnish. Goes left side to Anderson. Double hit called, however, on the Skyhawks. Lead extends to four.
Now if Michigan really wants to, Skyhawks are right around the 10-foot line and inside. They can start attacking the back row and really make a difference on the scoreboard with that adjustment.
Joust, Anderson, no lift called on Anderson. They thought they were going to call a lift, and then four hits called. Timeout called by Munciana as they had it tied twice in the past 10 points, reeling a bit now. 2015, SportsTownChicago.com, Alex.
This timeout is brought to you by Team Dow Wellness and their Health Tip of the Week. You want to find out what the Health Tip of the Week is? Go to the homepage at SportsTown Chicago for more information, or just listen to Fight Club Chicago every weekday from 3 to 5 as Steve, the one-man show, does it himself and also reads the Health Tip of the Week. Just a little way to better yourself if you don't feel like jumping in the cage and... taking some sort of fist or hand to the face.
Knee.
That's it.
Shin, foot. Some object that can cause pain to said face. If you're talking, you know, wrestling, could be a chair, a kendo stick, table.
A lot of options.
There are. There are countless options. 20-16, so good time out there by the Skyhawks to get their feet back underneath them.
And greatly needed as they were starting to miscommunicate. They were out of position on the defensive end in the last couple of rallies. So good timeout by their head coach.
Serve over. Quick one kill attempt. Good return there by Harnish. They're going for a long set on that one. Good block there by Bradbury, but the block sends it out of bounds. 21-16, we're back to five.
And again, just as it looked like the Skyhawks had made the adjustments during the timeout, a tool kill kills that momentum and gives Michigan... not just a point, but a chance to rebound.
Wright gets the point on that one as she did a better job playing it off the net. 21-17 now. Skyhawks bring it back to four.
And right now, if you're the Skyhawks, you got to make a little bit of a run.
High return. Bump back row. We're going near side with this one. Breaking through to the other side. Jess Marley, 22-17. Hard to trade off right now. This is not the time to you know, be trading off, I guess you should say.
Right, you got to go about 2-1, 3-1 in the points. Every other point right now, Michigan's got to like that.
Going out of bounds on a service error, good communication back row by Sarah McGuire, 23-18. Again, like you said, though, this is not the time to go 1-for-1.
And on court two, it appears that they might be going to three.
Good pickup there at the end of it by First Alliance Black as they got handled in the first one. They're going to three. They're doing the coin toss. First to 15, win by two. Back to our game, though. Harnish sets up outside. Tool block, tool kill. Kelsey Barker busting out the buzzsaw.
And the Skyhawks staying alive, trying to close this out, but I believe
they may have put the score on the wrong side. No, okay, I guess it's set point, though, 24-19. My apologies. Vasilakis outside, tip over the top. Waiting to see who got the point, and that's going to be all. Rotation 25-19 is the way this first one's going to end. Scoreboard changed a few times, so, you know, our apologies for that one. We'll be back in three, only finding it here on SportsTownChicago.com, live casting here from Sports Performance in Aurora, the Great Lakes Center, SportsTownChicago.com.
Hey guys, it's Pete McMurray. Every time I'm out and about, people always ask, Pete, how do I become a DJ? How can I hang out at cool concerts, go backstage, and most importantly, be on the air? Well, I'm here to tell you about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting trains you for a career in radio, TV, and web design on air and behind the scenes. Classes meet 3 days or nights a week, and in less than a year, you'll be ready to start your career in broadcasting. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting offers hands-on training, exciting internships, job placement assistance, and financial aid for those who qualify. They'll help get you into a career that you can love at their suburban campus in Lombard. They're enrolling now for upcoming classes and seats are filling up quickly. To get started, go to beonair.com/rock. That's beonair.com/rock, or you can text rock to 33239. That's rock to 33239. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin. Hey guys, it's Pete McMurray. Every time I'm out and about, people always ask, Pete, how do I become a DJ? How can I hang out at cool concerts, go backstage, and most importantly, be on the air? Well, I'm here to tell you about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting trains you for a career in radio, TV, and web design on air and behind the scenes. Classes meet 3 days or nights a week, and in less than a year, you'll be ready to start your career in broadcasting. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting offers hands-on training, exciting internships, job placement assistance, and financial aid for those who qualify. They'll help get you into a career that you can love at their suburban campus in Lombard. They're enrolling now for upcoming classes and seats are filling up quickly. To get started, go to beonair.com/rock. That's beonair.com/rock, or you can text rock to 33239. That's rock to 33239. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
Tribute there a week ago today, the one and the only Whitney Houston passing away, so gotta do a little tribute to her any way you can. She does want to dance with somebody, and I know a lot of these girls want to dance their way to a victory out there. We're going on the second set, 25-19 is the way the first one ends. It's going to be a exciting second one, as both teams were able to keep it fairly close. But then at the very end, Munsiana really just pulling away. You know, as we talked about, you can't do that exchange 2-for-1.
No, that you can't. And right now, this is going to be big for the Skyhawks to come out with a little bit of momentum and trying to now put Michigan on their heels.
Nasita sets up number 35, Jackson Jones, and getting the first point is going to be Michigan.
Yeah, Michigan doing exactly if you're a Skyhawks fan, hoping they didn't do, and that's come out picking up right where they left off.
Serve. Over. Nasita. And that one goes out of bounds on a service error. 1-1 your score.
And again, back and forth. At this point, though, in the second set, to start off, trading one for one is not such a bad thing. It's more what we saw at the end of the first set.
Bump, outside, high jump. Trying with kill attempt is going to be Reinders. Jackson goes for the kill. Bump back near corner by Marley. Sending it over, resetting up the attack for Michigan. Jackson gets blocked. 2-1 going to be your score as the Skyhawks, or excuse me, Michigan, leads by one.
And I just noticed looking at court number two, a player on First Alliance slipping, so maybe now court's going to start to come into play in terms of the moisture down on the surface.
Back to serve. The double three, Taylor Meyer, who is checked into the game, and she's not able to get under that kill attempt. 2-2, we're tied up.
Anderson seems to be a factor in the middle for Munciana. They got to find a way to get her a little more involved offensively, and I think that's going to pay off big dividends if they can do so.
2-2 your score. Serve over the top is going to be right. Long set, far side spike, double block, breaking through and having to drop right down. Kristen Leaders. Great play there. She's really got to start making an impact from that outside and just trying to force through that block that has definitely hindered them for so long.
Well, you definitely got to hold the block. If you go up for it, you got to make sure you hold it and keep it closed.
Jackson down. Action Jackson. Jenna Jendrick, high five. There we go. 3-3 your score, but Jackson, massive kill there.
And again, woo! Showing some power on the front line, something that Munciana really needs. And unfortunately, she checks right out, though.
High set, far side, spike down, breaking through that one. 68, Jess Marley. Right now, the left side is the attack zone for MVA.
And again, you know what? MVA seems to have the Skyhawks number defensively. They just seem to know where to go. And again, another headband on the floor.
Nora Mitros dives from one court to the other, pretty much. Back slide, tip over the top, right sends it far, but in. Just right. Wow, that one just teardropped into the end. 4-4 your score on that one.
And again, that one, MVA not expecting anything in the back row, just letting it go. The ball will sometimes drop your way, and now if you're the Skyhawks, you got to take advantage of knotting this up at four.
Serve into the net that time, though, is Mara Bradbury, the junior, 5-4, giving MVA that one-point advantage again.
It's going to be interesting to see. Skyhawks are staying here. They got another one in back-to-backs. So interesting to see if their coach changes up the rotation to try to keep legs fresh for what is essentially could be as many as six sets in a row.
I believe we have a rotational error called on Munciana, and 6-4 is going to be your score. Hop serve, Davis, spike down right, punching it alive, sending it back into play. Harnish over the top, quick, set, far side, spike off the top. Not able to get there is the unnumbered 10. Most it might be
numbered,
Nikki Box, because there's no number 3 out there.
Okay.
If you are not Nikki, again, my apologies, you are not on our official roster. 7-4, dig, down low. Side, bump, still alive. Marley, spike over the top. And when it was jousting time, Jackson Jones brought the heavier stick. 8-4.
And again, just a great job by the Skyhawks to go up and, not the Skyhawks, MVA. MVA, again, playing well at the net and using their height to their advantage.
Slide outside right, down right, kill. The right stuff. Maybe? No?
Are you referencing? I was trying to think, is that from something or just the movie?
New Kids on the Block. The right stuff. No.
No.
Never heard that song?
Never really listened to New Kids on the Block, so.
No, I understand that. It was It's an 80s, you know, kind of classic. I you know, along the lines of whatever 80s classics are. 9-5 your score. SportsOnChicago.com, a league of our own. Don't forget, folks, videos are all available on the live stream account. Just click along the bottom and get our audio with it. Or if you want to just download the audio, hey, you could do that too. Just go to SportsOnChicago.com. And find the President's Challenge right off the homepage. 5-9 your score. Make it 6-9 now.
Well, just think, this time last year was just audio. This year there's video. Just think what next year could be.
Now, don't set him up.
I'm just pointing out that, you know, lots change, and in just a year, we've come a long way.
That's true. 9-6, still your score on SportsTownChicago.com. Back to serve is going to be Vasilakis. High, bump, Nasita, right hand over the top. High set for Jackson. Bumping it, almost going out of bounds, but able to catch up to it in time. It's going to be Groh. Quick one set, decoy, Jackson redirects it. No lift called on that one. Back bump by Jackson Jones. Quick one set, decoy again going for Jackson. Jackson double blocked as they had all six players within that 10-foot line. It was all or nothing. And that's again, O-Town, because I want it all or nothing at all.
And again, we kind of have that coach's perspective of the game tape.
Yeah.
And again, when you see all the players converge like that near the 10-foot line in the middle of the court, if you're on the side of Michigan, your eyes have to light up knowing that if you send anything near the back row, you're going to be going
home. I still got that pit bull in my head, or is it Flo Rida? Give me everything tonight. 6-10, your score. Decoy across middle, high self-preservation there by Davis. Quick one, trying to get the kill is right. We continue along, two-hand high set there. Right goes for the kill. Again, the right stuff. 10-7.
Now, is that on the playlist for tonight?
No. High fives to Niski and Kennard here. West Chicago represented. Hopefully they've been winning so we can call them on courts one and two. Winning so far? Have you been winning? You don't want to talk about it. You're one and one. We'll keep winning so we can call you in the next few days. We're here all weekend. Okay, well, does that count? Is it like a weighted score? It's on points. Okay. We'll keep winning. And get me some bumping pads. I'm still waiting for them. I want to sit here and just in case something comes my way. I'm just saying. Live radio, folks. We got video this time, too. It's all fancy. Video casting the whole thing. We're fancy people now. Hold on. Wait for it. There you go. So that's along with what we're saying. So that's why you got to win. So, you know, you get all this coverage. Have your peeps at home. Tune in. Hot dogs and apples, the choice of all-stars here at the President's Day Challenge. Any thoughts on these two teams? Do you know anybody that plays for MVA or Munsiana Skyhawks? So, okay. Well, 11-10, your score, timeout on the court. Ladies, by all means, congratulations on 1-1. Hopefully you make it here. No problem. Ms. Kennard right there. You want to grab a microphone? You want to talk with us? You sure? Well, I'm not either. I just talk. There's a difference. You want to jump on? We're just gonna hand it to in
if
general.
If you hand a microphone...
They're getting all embarrassed. 11-10, your score, Alex. Things continue along here. We might have to go to three.
Well, Michigan's came out fast out of the gates, and then all of a sudden now some miscommunication on defense, some poor rotation in the back row, and the Skyhawks find themselves right back in it.
Right-hand serve over the top. Good bump back row. Huge slide. Spike down. Harnish not able to get to that one in time. Was that a good slide? Okay. Great slide. How's your arm feeling? I you're like a world record holder in our books with 64 kill attempts in the, you know, state down there. My arm started to hurt. Serve over. Bump from the back row. Left hand, no lift called on that one. Breaking through, Mara Bradbury, junior, 5'10", on the cusp of being 6 foot. I'll never see that in my lifetime. I'm probably the shortest one here next to that one libero from the other game, but, you know. 12-11 your score. We continue on. High bump outside. Spike along the line. Good dig down low. High in the air, and I believe, a double hit called. Do you agree with the call? Double hit?
It's The one thing I've noticed, though, it's interesting going from court one to court two, the officiating is much different between the two on the number of lifts or double hits being called. It seemed like on court two, we really weren't getting much of anything.
12-12 your score. They gotta wear some comfortable shoes, those R1s. Because R2s rotate, the lines rotate, but the R1s, they are there all day.
But they're all wearing the same shoes, it looks like, too.
At least white ones. Like, you know, shoes that people wear in the hospital, just really nice.
That actually really does. That's what the R1 on court two looks like, nursing shoes. I don't know what the actual term is for that, but I'll call it nursing shoes.
That's fine. Hey, props to nurses. Well, game three ended. Not quite sure who came out victorious for court number two, but we continue along. Good bump, far side, Harnish with the slide. Left hand. What a smart play that time by number six, Kelsey Barker, was going up to try to get right, switched to the left hand, and found some space in there, 14-13.
Well, you got to be – right now the Skyhawks have really turned things around, playing with a lot more – aggression than they were earlier, and that confidence has really dictated the way this second set has gone.
Redirection there by Abby Fleener, 15-13. She's number 99. I expect like Dakota Hampton to have that number, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you would think so. And that's one of the few names I actually did not see on the list here today. On the rosters, I was looking through.
She's a 17.
Okay.
So we haven't looked through our 17s yet. That's this afternoon for you.
That is.
Alex Cicero and Joe Fredo going to be doing the afternoon call. 16-13 your score. SportsTownChicago.com, a league of our own. Got one more after this, Alex, until our break?
Two more.
Good to know.
This is 4 of 6 in the morning session.
Awesome. Set, near side, the nameless wonder, number 10, sends it over, 10-foot line. High return that time is going to be by McGuire. Dig down low. What a smart play. What an absolutely smart play. Alyssa Davis, seeing that the rotation brought everything over for the block, redirects the left one. 16-13, and we got a timeout on the court.
And Michigan right back on top by three. And again, Michigan, when they play and pass the ball well with confidence, the Skyhawks haven't had an answer. It's when the Skyhawks can themselves get in position and put Michigan on their heels that they've been able to hang tough. But right now, Michigan right now is sitting pretty. Scoreboard just changed during this timeout, so I'm kind of confused.
It was 16-13, and then with that point, somebody made it 17. We'll just go with it.
But for those of you at home, if you want to do what we're doing, broadcasting volleyball, check out beonair.com. It's part of the Illinois and Ohio Center for Broadcasting. For those of you in Michigan, you can pretty much choose between the two states of Ohio or Illinois. And if you really want to go out west, we do have a Denver campus.
Travel west, my son, haven't you been told? California's cool. 17-13, we continue along. Two-hand directional set. Picking up cleanly is Harnish. Near side, left-hand uppercut. Good play to keep it alive there for MVA. Quick one set, redirected down. Oh, great dig on that one. Harnish, quick one again. You should only need it twice. She didn't want it to go three. Give it up for the one, the only, Kelsey Barker. The price was right on that one.
Oh boy.
Wow. Yes.
Wow.
So it keeps me awake here, folks, coming up with horrible one-liners. 18-14 your score. Lead extends back to 4 points.
I'm pretty sure, though, that's really what people are tuning in for. They're tuning in for the one-liners, and pretty much that's it.
Serving over, going to be Davis. Spike along the far side, breaking through and finding the gap again is Barker as she checks out of the game. That is going to be Wise on that one.
You think about it, though, no sport is probably built better towards the one-liners than volleyball because you get to deliver them every, like, 30 seconds.
Yeah, you know. I was thinking about that, too, because, you know, in football, if somebody gets a touchdown, odds are they're not going to get a second one in the day. Probably the kicker would get the most say. Sacks, maybe you get one a day. You know, everything is, like, one, maybe two times. Maybe if you do receptions in football, and I'm just using that as an analogy. Softball every hit. The only other good thing, the only other time you can do it, point goes to MVA. The only other thing I could think of is if you're a pitcher, every strikeout. So you may have 10 or so calls, especially in softball, where they're just, you know.
But in terms of the numbers of players, like with every player here, you essentially have the opportunity to come up with something, a nickname that you say plenty of times throughout the action. Basketball, maybe?
Possibly. There you go.
Just because of the
But see, unless it's a dunk, though, because a regular two-pointer doesn't have the impact of a kill, you know, where everybody can stop and celebrate for a few seconds.
On the radio side, no one's going to know that.
That's true. Tell me I'm doing my job wrong. I get it, Alex.
I'm just saying.
You know, last year you're intern Alex. This year you're an employee, and now you tell me I suck. I get it. 15-19 is your score. Spike outside, double block, high return. Davis to the far side. Tip high in the air is going to be by Reinders, but able to return is Harnish. Picking it up is going to be the Oliveira and the Sita. Bump over. Harnish, quick one, redirection. Davis keeps it alive. Nasita, 10-foot line, and sending it into the net after a very long rally is Hannah Groh.
I'm curious to know the numbering, though, that Michigan went with. I see an 85 out there, a 67. Talk about just...
Offensive lineman. It's like an offensive lineman type of thing. That's all I can go with. I really got nothing else.
Here, Olivero's 32. I've never
Ricky
seen...
Ricky Waters.
Ricky
never.
Williams, whoever.
We have done high school through college here, folks. Club level, never seen sets of numbers like this. It's throwing me off, too, because the list they, you know, not to make excuses, but the list we got this morning 4 minutes before the whole thing started, they're not even in numerical order. So I'm like, okay. At least I can say them night or right. Right at night. 16-20, your score. Spike, far side. Nasita goes back 10-foot line. Davis goes far corner. Picked up by Velakis. And not able to dive in time is going to be Hannah Groh. And 17-20 your score on SportsTownChicago.com.
I think in terms of the numbers, 1 through 20 for libero is kind of like the quarterbacks like we were talking about. 20 to 40 should be for the setters because they're like the running backs. They're always running the offense and they're always involved. And then your like glamour position would be the outside hitter in the 80s.
Huge slide, kill. Do you like the idea still of the middles being?
I think the middles and the linemen.
Yeah.
Numbers, yeah.
I'm going to sit.
Which pretty much you could give them, 60 through 80, 60 up to like 79 and then give them the 90s as well.
Spike across the middle. Jackson Harnish picks it up. No net by, they are calling, they're calling four hits, saying it, they never got it over the net. So 22-17 your score, SportsTownChicago.com.
Non-libero's defensive specialist, your 50s for the linebackers. There we go.
I could just see our friend Hennessy Reyes over at DePaul wearing a nice 55, you know.
Yeah.
The Cinco e Cinco. 23-17. Oh, big, massive kill. Taylor Wright. Woo, 23-18.
Can you imagine just saying everyone's just her number in Spanish for next year's season?
I don't remember how to say service error. That one goes out of bounds. 24-18, we're at game point.
Cincuenta cinco?
Is that how you say 50?
I don't know. I'm trying to think.
Right hand, set serve. Over the top by Reinders. Set near side. Jackson off the double block. Good dig down low. Oh, good dig over to the side is Meyer. Back set is going to be Nasita. Jackson from the middle, double block. Not able to take a stab at it. Is going to be Reinders, and we're making it 24-20 now.
And Michigan with a chance, I believe. Upserve's going to go to Montana. I thought I saw a ball roll over to the other side. Apparently did not.
Right hand set serve. Oh, apparently they just didn't give anybody a point on that one. Right hand over the top. Maybe something rolled in and we didn't see. Set. Far side, spike off, double block, sends it out of bounds. And points going to go to MVA. And game's going to go to MVA. Winning in two straight. We got two more games left in this one, Alex. For SportsTownChicago.com, again, Michigan Volleyball Academy 18-1s with coach and director Mame Valestra taking out Muncie Skyhawks West Lyon, and Aaron Harrison will be back in just about 10 minutes. Who do we got coming up next, Alex?
Well, we got our choice because both courts 1 and 2 have not started yet. All teams we have seen, we are either going to have the Skyhawks taking on Ice or we're going to have First Alliance Black taking on the Thunder. Both are going to start in less than 10 minutes.
Okay. Well, we'll regroup. We'll figure out what we want to do, and we'll be back. SportsTownChicago.com.
Hey, this is Dr. Pete, SportsTownChicago.com, inviting you to check out the Team Dow Wellness Tip of the Week.